This is our 11th year. It's our 11th year. And the time spent is what has really brought it to the level that they are. Mm. They really are on a level. There is not just.
But you're international now.
Yeah, we are. You know, this is our second year now, already invited to Miami next year to open the graduation for AUC. And this is so incredible, OG, because I remember the first time I met them, this lady used to be coming across by the center every Saturday. I never knew who she was, but she was just watching the development of the band. And then 2 months after she approached me and told me she's from the AUC, what they're doing, and they would like to, like to have us in the graduation. They look for something that is Caribbean. Yeah. Since they're here, they wanted to change what they do in the States, because they find that's boring. So want something more, more flurry and so forth. So I wrote something for them, and we put something together, and they accepted it. And since then, they has been one of the biggest support, I would say. I mean, they have programs. We go to them. We do sometimes fun things with the kids. They would give little workshops on sex education, on what you call it, AHBO. Mm. They do the tying of the knots and bandaging, things like that, you know. And it's really has been good. They supported us financially as well. Sometimes when you want a little sponsor, we get it from them. And then it was after the hurricane.
Yeah.
I was getting some message, but someone was not looking for me. And then one day she came and she said, "We've been looking for you all over. We want to take you guys to Miami." I said, "To do what?" She said, "Our graduation." I said, "Okay. Miami has tons of marching bands."
Yeah.
And great. So I was like, wait a minute. Anyhow, we went. It was a smash the first time. And I thought it would stop there, but they said, no. We do it again. This was the program in St. Martin. They want to keep that up.
Yeah.
So we went this year again. And they already invited us for next year. So we have to keep this up. We have to keep them sometimes. You want to stop because it's like, it's ups and downs.
But
you know?
It's good. Yeah.
Yeah, because they have school. Some of them get older. They leave. They go to work. Some go on with the study. So it's always a new batch. Come in, you know. At one time, we had 100 something kids.
Wow.
Yeah, but it keep fluctuating.
You're below 100 now?
No. So now we have about, I would say maybe 22 right now. We have a solid core right now that are there. Oh. You know, maybe 22 with some new ones. You know, slowly again some new ones coming in. You know, it's very manageable now.
Yeah.
And but I think most. Quit because sometimes it's the rigidness. Sometimes the rigidness that they cannot keep to.
You practice
the
often.
Right now, no. We practice Thursdays and Saturdays. Oh. We had the days that we used to practice every day. But that's what it took to reach the level that they are now. You know, and I don't think I'll go back there because I don't have that energy to do this no more, you know.
So a young man like this one here, that's been with the band for
6 years.
6 years now. He can very well stay with the band for what, another 6 years?
Yes, but that's the reason why I start at 5.
Okay.
You see, when I start at 5, you got a good span to 18. Mm. You know, you have a good span and you keep them and you have something that is good. But if you start if I start at 12 or 13, it's not a long time, you know. But then developing from 5, by the time they hit 10, they are well groomed.
Understand, you were asking to do solos, man.
Yeah, I was asking to do solos. And that was when I was very small, so at that type of age, I didn't know what I was doing. Mm-hmm. But drumming was my passion. My grandmother tell me in my mother's womb, I was pounding on my mother's stomach.
Yeah.
That's what she told me. I don't know if it's true, because.
If she tells her so, believe
it. She tell me that if it's like that. Yeah. She tell me it's like that.
Yeah, so you come out a drummer?
Yes, I came out a drummer.
Uh-huh.
I have a music background. My grandfather, he was a musician. Mm. He used to play the guitar in Nevis. He was in a band, but I don't know the band's name. But he was in a band playing the guitar.
Oh, that's good. So, can you do a solo for us tonight?
Solo? Reason, like, where? What to do it on the table?
Yeah. That's good, man. Imagine that you're doing that without drums.
Very high table as well.